Warning: to avoid personal injury and damage to the product, use extreme care not to puncture, twist, or crack the battery. An internal puncture or rupture to the battery has the potential to cause a short, which may result in a thermal event. Before you begin, remove the display panel assembly. Removal: remove the two 2.3mm P1 Phillips head screws that secure the touchscreen cable bracket to the system board. Remove the touchscreen cable bracket. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the touchscreen ZIF connector and disconnect the touchscreen ribbon cable from the system board. Remove the touchscreen ribbon cable from the adhesive that secures it to the battery. Remove the 2.5mm P1 Phillips head screw that secures the left bezel frame to the display enclosure. Lift the left bezel frame off of the system board and remove. Remove the four 2mm P1 Phillips head screws that secure the battery to the display enclosure. While supporting the battery with both hands, carefully lift the top edge off of the alignment pins and slide the bottom edge out from under the retention tabs on the display enclosure and remove. Replacement. While supporting the battery with both hands, tow the lower edge under the retention tabs on the display enclosure and lower it onto the alignment pins. Replace the four 2mm P1 Phillips head screws that secure the battery to the display enclosure. Place the left bezel frame into position on the system board. Replace the 2.5mm P1 Phillips head screw that secures the left bezel frame to the display enclosure. Insert the touchscreen ribbon cable into the touchscreen ZIF connector on the system board and press the locking bar down to lock the cable into place. Apply pressure along the length of the touchscreen ribbon cable to adhere it to the battery. Place the touchscreen cable bracket into position on the system board. Replace the two 2.3mm P1 Phillips head screws that secure the touchscreen cable bracket to the system board.